Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, now we are going to talk about the periodic trends of the alkali metals. In the previous lecture, we have got to know that SBOC elements are being divided into two parts, that is alkali metals and alkaline earth metals. So now we are going to talk about the periodic trends of the alkali metals. So now let us talk about that. So, talking about the periodic table, we know that the S block element are present at the extreme left of the periodic table, and they are being divided into two groups, that is group 1 and group 2. So basically we are going to talk about the periodic trend of the alkali metals, that is group 1 elements. And so talking about the periodic trends, there are certain periodic trends from which we could understand that the value changes, like for example like atomic size, like ionization enthalpy, like nuclear charge, etc. So now let us start with the first one, that is atomic size. So talking about the atomic size first, because this is also a trend that we could observe in the group 1 elements, because the atomic size, it also, that is, it increases down the group. So let us understand what is atomic size, and then we could understand what are the trend or what are the changes that we could observe along the group 1. So talking about the definition of it, that is the atomic size, as we know already, but let us understand it again. That is the distance between the nucleus and the outermost electron of an atom which is belonging to an element is known as atomic size or atomic radius of that particular atom. So since we are talking about the group 1 element, or since we are talking about the alkali elements or alkali metals, so talking about the first element that we have, that is, we understand that it is basically lithium, then sodium, then potassium, cesium, rubidium, francium, and so on. So if I talk about that is lithium, so lithium is the one which is below, which is basically the first element of the group 1, because we are not considering here as hydrogen, because the hydrogen is basically somewhere different from that of the that is the group 1 elements, that is from lithium to francium. As well as we know that all these are metals, that is from lithium to francium, we are talking about the metals, and the hydrogen, it is present in a gaseous state. So that's the reason the place of the hydrogen is not exact above the lithium, but it is between the group 1 and the group 18, and at the topmost of the periodic table. And because of the property which is comparatively different from that of the group 1 elements, and which is very much similar to that of the that is since it has a gaseous property, so therefore hydrogen is not placed in the group 1 here. So now let us talk about the lithium first. So talking about the lithium, lithium is the first member of the group 1 element, and since that's the reason that as we move across the period, we know that the atomic size decreases. The reason behind that is the atomic number also increases, as well as we could see that the number of electrons also increases, and as a result the size decreases along the period. But when we are that is concerned with the atomic size along the group, so we know that along the group the atomic number increases very rapidly. The reason behind it, suppose if I would consider that is lithium, which has an atomic number of 3, I would write it over here, and then talking about sodium, it is 11, and then it is basically potassium, then it is 90. So suppose if I am considering in this example, so in this case I could observe that the atomic number increases very rapidly, and that's the reason that obviously if the atomic number increases, then we could also say that the atomic shell, means I would like to say that the number of orbits also increases, and because of that we could see that the atomic size also increases, and that's the reason that is along the group 1, that is from lithium to francium, the atomic number increases, along with that of the number of shell also increases, and ultimately we could say that is the atomic size also increases. So for example, if I am talking about lithium, so lithium the electronic configuration could be written in this way, that is 1s2 2s1. So similarly for sodium, I could write it as like 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 and 3s1, and so on it will go. So here it is clearly indicated that the number of shell also increases, and then how we could say that the since the atomic number also increases, and because the last electron, it doesn't add up in the same shell. Like for example, if I would talk about this lithium, so the last electron is it's in that is 2s orbital, and or also we could say that in the s orbital. By talking about the last electron of that is sodium, it doesn't add up in the 2s orbital. Meanwhile, it adds up in that is 3s orbital, and this 3 indicates the principal quantum number, and it also indicates that the it is belonging to the third main shell. So that's the reason that it will go on increasing, and we could find that as the atomic size it increases from that is lithium to francium. So this is the first that is the trend that we have talked about, that is atomic size or atomic radius. So now let us move on to the next one, and that is and the second periodic trend is nuclear charge. So what is nuclear charge? Let us understand that. That is the attraction of the nucleus of an atom, of an element, to the electron belonging to the outermost shell is known as nuclear charge. So therefore, nuclear charge is nothing but the force of attraction between the nucleus, which is present in the center of the atom, towards the outermost electron. And since we know that nucleus consists of proton as well as it also consists of that is neutron, and that's the reason that nucleus is overall it is a positively charged particle, or it is a positively charged space, where we could find that the positively charged space is now attracted towards the negatively charged electron. And this kind of force of attraction, since the force of attraction would be more if the distance between the nucleus and the outermost electron will be less. But recently we have got to know about the atomic size, and in that case we have got to know that is the atomic size, it goes on increasing down the group, that is from lithium to francium. So that's the reason that since the distance between the nucleus and the outermost electron, it will be very much less in lithium, when we are concerning about the lithium atomic size. So we could find that the attraction of the nucleus towards the outermost electron of the lithium, it will be more. And if you compare it with that is the francium, and francium, as we know, that it has the more atomic size, and that's the reason that the nucleus will not have that much of attraction with the outermost electron. That's the reason that the nuclear charge actually it decreases down the group, and that's the reason we could also clarify that the lithium has more nuclear charge compared to that of the francium. This is also applicable by understanding the electronic configuration that we have did earlier also. So we could say that that the third electron of the lithium, that is it is very much close to that of the nucleus of the lithium. By talking about the last electron of the francium, it is very far away from the nucleus, and that's the reason there is no kind of force of attraction, and that's why we could say that the nuclear charge decreases down the group. So this was the second that is trend that I was talking about, and that is what it changes. And now let us move on to the next one, and that is so talking about the next one, that is ionization enthalpy. So what is ionization enthalpy? Let us understand it first. And we have the definition of that. That is the minimum energy required to remove one mole of an electron from one mole of a gaseous atom is known as ionization enthalpy. So basically it deals with that is to remove the outermost electron, or basically the loosely bonded electron of an atom. So for example, the minimum energy that has been required so as to remove the loosely bonded electron of an atom is basically known as ionization enthalpy. And ionization enthalpy is basically is being concerned with that is of one mole of an atom, or you could say that one atom, and we have to, from the one atom, we have to remove one electron. So suppose if we have one mole of atom, and they all are present in a gaseous state, and for which we have to that is remove one mole of electron from each of the atom, and that also we could say that the loosely bonded electron. So, therefore, the energy that has been required so as to remove the loosely bonded electron is basically known as ionization enthalpy, and that has a unit of that is kilojoule per mole. So that is this much amount of energy has been required so as to remove one mole of an electron from a one mole of a gaseous atom. So since we are talking about that is atom which has been present in a gaseous state, or we could also call it as an isolated state where it has not been bonded with any kind of atoms. And since we are talking about individual atom, and for which we have to give a particular kind of energy so as that one mole of electron could be liberated, and or one mole of electron could be removed. So that is basically known as ionization enthalpy. So how this ionization enthalpy is related to atomic size and nuclear charge? Let us talk about that. So for example, if I am talking about the atomic size, so atomic size is somewhere, it is basically as we got to know, that is along the group, it actually increases. The reason behind that is it increases because the last electron enters in the outermost shell and it enters the that is a new shell. So how ionization enthalpy is basically is related to atomic size as well as it is related to nuclear charge. Let us talk about that. So for example, if I'm talking about the atomic size, so atomic size, as we know, for the group, that is, it increases down the group, and that's the reason that it increases because the last electron enters in the next shell. For example, if I'm talking about lithium, so the last electron is present in the second shell. By talking about the sodium, it is present in the third shell. So therefore, the number of shell, it increases, and that's the reason we could say that the atomic size also increases. But how about the nuclear charge? So nuclear charge, as we know, that is, if the atomic size increases, then the nuclear charge also decreases. And according to that, we could say that is the ionization enthalpy. So this is basically the thing that we are going to talk about. So talking about lithium, so lithium is the one which has basically the least atomic size. That's the reason we could say that the nuclear charge is also more. And somehow if you have to remove the electron or the loosely bonded electron, that is the outermost electron, then for that we have to require more energy. So more energy has been required just to remove the outermost or just to remove the loosely bonded electron of the atom of the lithium. And that is the reason that the more energy has been required, and we could say that the ionization enthalpy of lithium is more compared to that of francium. Suppose if you are talking about francium, as we know that francium is the one which has the most that is highest atomic size, and that's the reason that the nuclear charge is also very less. And now it is very much easy for us to remove the electron or to remove the outermost electron. So therefore we could say that since the atomic size is also more of francium, as well as we can also say that the nuclear charge is very much less for the francium atom, that's the reason we could say that the ionization enthalpy of the francium is very much less, and that's the reason that electrons can be easily removed from the francium rather than that electrons can't be easily removed from that of the lithium, because of the more energy is being required to remove the electron from the outermost orbit. So this was related to ionization enthalpy, and now let me give you a short glimpse that what we have did in this overall lecture. So talking about periodic trend, so when it comes to atomic size, we could say that the atomic size increases down the group. And if you talk about that is the nuclear charge, so the nuclear charge actually decreases down the group, that is from lithium to francium. And now ultimately we could say that is for ionization enthalpy, it also decreases down the group. So this all three, at least the periodic trend that we have talked about in this lecture. So there are also certain kind of properties like electronegativity. So now talking about the other properties like electronegativity. So electronegativity is something which is basically the tendency of an atom to attract the shared pair of electrons towards itself. So since we are talking about the lithium, so if we are comparing lithium with that of the francium, then we could understand that lithium is the one which is basically having less atomic size, as well as it has basically more ionization enthalpy. So that's the reason that it also has more nuclear charge, and that's the reason it will have an attraction towards the electron, and that would be considered to be more electronegative compared to that of the other one, that is strontium, which is basically more electropositive. So therefore, these are also a certain kind of property that, or certain kind of trend that we could talk about. So for now, this is it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly and you have got to know about the periodic tables or about the alkali metals. So I hope you will share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.